a very warm welcome to Geronya!
I always wanted to be brought up to a keyboard version of a Final Countdown. Thank you. You made dreams come true, Captain Tan. You made dreams come true, man.
Got you.
Thank you guys for being here. Bill, Zilla, give it up for Zilla. This show is fucking amazing, man. I had a birthday recently. I'm realizing now, as I get like a little bit older, that as you get older, your perception of what's cool starts to change, right? Like when I was a kid, I thought my dad was the coolest person in the world because he spoke like a jazz musician. Like he would single me out when he picked me up from school. And he'd look at me and be like, "Hey, babe, how's it going? How's everything? Yeah, you doing good? Yeah, that's my son. You getting good grades in school? Guess what? Grades don't matter if you're cool, baby. How about my fucking back?" And I look at all the other kids, I'm like, "Oh, my dad's so cool, oh my god." And then I got older and realized that's just how drunk people speak, guys, that's it. One day I was at home, I was like, "Oh my god, he's not cool, he's just coping, I get it. Being an adult is hard, I get it." I mean, we're in a relationship with my dad, man. Saw domestic violence as a kid. Toward the end of my parents' marriage, my dad would come home really late at night and he would just start screaming for my mom to come downstairs, you know? And he'd be like, "Val, get down here, this house is filthy, I'm gonna teach you how to clean up this house tonight, Val, get down here." And my mom, she was so brave because every single night she would go downstairs and beat his ass. Like, really bad. Like, sometimes I wouldn't even know what would happen. I would just go downstairs and there'd be dad-shaped holes in all the walls. And then, like, my dad, like, voting. I was like, "What the fuck? What is happening here?" Yeah. He's like, "Hey, man, I've been thinking about, I don't like black McDonald's commercials." I don't like it. This audience is mostly white. I don't like how you guys clapped either. Where my point was going to be. Y'all were like, "Yeah, I see you." No, I don't like black McDonald's commercials, man. I feel like they're emotionally manipulative, you know? Because they'll do some shit where they'll have like a dad and his son, and they expect me to watch the commercial and be like, "Oh my god, that was so beautiful. I'm about to go fill this dad-shaped hole with a Big Mac." So beautiful. I hate them, man. Because it's like a father and a son in the commercial. They have a conversation that's absolutely meaningless. You think it's going to have some meaning, but it doesn't. Like the dad, the son's just like, "Dad, why you take me McDonald's?" And the dad's like, "Well, because when I was a kid, my dad took me to McDonald's." I'm like, "What? That's it?" "Just like my dad, I love you, son." And he takes a bite of the cheeseburger and a single tear rolls down his face. And then they do a hip hop outro like, "Boom, boom, 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 boom." Black kids with dads. Like, no McDonald's. No, not gonna get me. Not with that McDonald's. Oh man. I feel like kids see porn way too early nowadays. No? Like I feel like maybe that's one of the ways that I know I'm getting older is that I feel like kids are seeing, like I care about what kids see. So, no. Because they don't even have to search for it. They just go on Google Chrome and type in P-O and then Google Chrome is like, "Oh yeah, Pornhub, I got you right this way, baby boy. Right this way to Titty Town, here you go, just waving them in." Like if I ever have kids, I want them to see porn for the first time the same way that I saw it. My teacher fucking up a computer class, like that's the only way to see it. It's the only way to see it. And my teacher was like, "Hey everybody, go to whitehouse.com And then we went to whitehouse.com, and then Bresch just pops up on everybody's screen, and then for like 10 seconds we thought Miss Campbell was the best teacher ever. I'm like, oh my God, Miss Campbell did this? Yeah, she's really trying to get a Kids' Choice Award. Like, that's what she's trying to get. She's trying to get a Kids' Choice Award. She saw what we were all looking at. She was like, oh my God, kids, I'm at whitehouse.gov. Go to whitehouse.gov, my job depends on it. And we're like, hey everybody, go to whitehouse.gov. We can't lose Miss Campbell. Her mistakes lead to titties. Go right now. It was an amazing class. I think my favorite part of class, though, was the very end of class, right? The bell rang. She was like, hold on, wait, kids, before you leave. I know we learned a lot today. This is very important. Here's how you delete browser history. Get it all, children. Even the cookies, y'all. Get the cookies, too. Leave no trace, children. Leave no trace. Burn the computers. Yeah, I've been in New York for like 10 years now. This is cool. I had my 10-year anniversary in June, which is pretty dope. Sure, you can clap at me slowly losing my fucking mind. You can clap at that. Because New York makes you petty. Like, I feel like a lot of people don't realize just how petty they get living in New York. The other day, I got into an argument with a dude on the subway platform, right? I realized it was dumb. I was like, all right, this is stupid. I started to walk away and I was like, hey, you have a nice day, man. All I hear behind me is, you have a better one, bitch! What level of petty do you have to be at to want me to have a better day than you? And what level of petty did I have to be at to turn around and go, oh, you want me to have the best day of my life? That's impossible, because you're going to have the best day of your life, you stupid piece of shit. He's like, oh, I'm going to have the best day of my life. Oh, you have life-changing epiphanies, you dumb motherfucker. I was like, you want me to have epiphanies? You want me to have epiphanies? I mean, I don't want to have an epiphany. You know what? I'll give kids and never hungry again, you dumb piece of shit. He's like, oh, you don't bring my kids into this, your mind, you monster. I was like, yeah, fuck your kids. Oh, they never starve, bitch. He's like, oh. That's actually not what happened. That's not what happened. What happened was, I started to walk away. I was like, hey, you have a nice day. And all I heard behind me was, you have a better one, bitch. And I turned around and I said, what did you just say to me? And he was like, keep walking or I'm going to slice your face. So I kept walking. That's what happened. Because no.